Hunger shames the vegan cult, harming kids. The Daily Telegraph, Sydney, Australian newspaper, Monday, December 24. Story about vegans not giving their children enough dairy products to help their bones, to fix their bones. Not giving them enough meat for their iron. They're harming kids. They're basing this on one family who had a child who was malnourished. But what are the major countries with the highest osteoporosis? I think America's number one. Us milk drinking countries have higher bone problems than any other country. I'm not going to read through the story. It's kind of a bit boring. I mean, if you wanted to freeze the screen, you could kind of go through that. But this couple here have had their child taken away because they must have been doing something wrong. I'm sure there's more to the story. They did have a malnourished kid and they had the kid on a vegan diet. These are some of the things they said was wrong with the child when it was admitted to hospital. Interesting. But I'll read this bit here with you because I find it quite alarming. Vegan diets are based on denial. Knowledge gained during the years required to gain a medical degree, and even knowledge gained over many years of medical practice, represents far more than just the total number of that time. Medical science accumulates over centuries. Every generation of new experts builds upon those centuries of wisdom. A first-year medical student may now know far more about the workings of the human body than did the world's foremost surgeon of the 18th century. Yet, a modern student could not have attained that awareness without the labor of those who have previously studied and learned and passed down their insights. Well, I've put up a video before of my mate who got cut from ear to ear around the throat based on a doctor's lie that he had cancer, and he didn't. I'll put that link down below so you can see what my mate's got to say and what happened to him based on doctors fucking up. Lying, making money from surgeries. Anyway, back to the vegans. Those dangerous vegans, sorry. And yet, we now have vegan mothers who simply discard all those centuries of accumulated comprehension just because they don't believe it. Worse still, their willful ignorance puts at risk the health of extremely young children who are, without any say in the matters, put on vegan diets. I mean, that's damn dangerous, but you've watched, you know, parents give their kids under 5 year olds massive energy drinks, mothers V drinks. That's not bad. These people should be locked up for giving their kids this crap or lollies and all the other crap and harmful chemicals in that food. As an investigation by the Daily Telegraph reveals, well, that's a top investigation, Australian vegan mothers are commenting online with fellow vegans about turning their backs on science, and they are being congratulated for it. The doctor basically said that a vegan diet is irresponsible and that I could even hinder his brain development by not giving him meat, one mother told the site Vegan Baby Led Weaning. My doctor said some things I really don't believe, so I wanted some veggie mums. Opinions rate another. Just consider the implications of that line, my doctor said. Some things I really don't believe. Like, you've got to believe a doctor. Fuck, like my mate did. This represents a denial of human achievement built upon since intelligent life was first established on Earth. There, these people are intelligent. That's why they're turning their back, because they're seeing too much medical mishap and people getting harmed by pharmaceutical drugs and unintelligent doctors. It is a basic denial of thought, and it is all in the same of a diet cult. The doctor who warned one vegan mother an exclusionary diet could hinder brain development was telling the truth. No less an authority than AMA President Dr. Tony Barton notes that parents who place their children on strict vegan diets run the risk of leaving those children with iron and calcium deficiencies. Okay, get them back on your dairy. Like I said, have a Google. Milk drinking countries have the worst osteoporosis there is. How many children have snot running out their face? Ear problems, coughing up lots of phlegm. This is all due to mostly to do with dairy. I've seen it so many times. I'm not a doctor, but how many times have I seen kids and lots of people get really sick from dairy and don't even know it? They just keep drinking dairy. They're developing mucus. Like I said, blocked sinuses and ear problems. Get off dairy. If you're having breast milk, man, you're a human. Since when did a human put their babies on a cow? We're the only species on the planet that suckle from another species. But we're smart. Due to the developing nature of their brains and bones, the consequences of nutritional deficiencies in children can be catastrophic, Dr. Barton said. This is not a matter of opinion or belief. This is nothing to do with feelings or theories. This is fact, plain and simple, that, all children should be on a cow. Obviously. Gee, that's not it. Don't anyone get that? Put your child on a cow. Fucking idiots.